road. I'm gonna ride till I can't go more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel, Rageful Peace. Anyways, what I was saying, welcome to my channel, guys, Rageful Peace. Thank you for the subscriber, and please watch my video and hit like and put some comment. Tonight I was thinking I'm gonna give you guys a private visit, and we're gonna dive deep inside my brain. All my brain react with my ADHD and my PTSD. Lots of D. Remember that? I'm gonna try to make you guys understand a little bit better. On my previous video, I was saying special need and stuff like that. The same thing with mental health. PTSD doesn't want mean it's gonna be exactly the same for each and every one of us out there with PTSD or ADHD. You have a lot of similar symptoms, but it's not everybody who take that the same way and will feel the same way and react the same way. And I'm gonna help you guys to understand a little bit better how my brain work. And hopefully you guys are gonna be interesting by it. And hopefully you guys are gonna be able to keep up with me. Sometime I can jump from one subject to another. That is one of my strong side for myself, for my PTSD. I can flip in a dime, you know, my mind go from one extreme to the other. What I decided to do in 15 minutes, and we can get ready in the family to do this, and poof, nah, change my mind, something else come by. Just like internet, I jump from one platform to another in a split second, and that for the people around me can be very, very, very complicated and very hard to deal with. And plus, you know, the side effect of the PTSD will kick in with that and amplified some other stuff and create a lot of conflict, you know. But you know, I have to tell you that not the PTSD, I can get rid of it. Oh, please, if people can take PTSD away, because I tell you, to take the PTSD away, first of all, it's going to have lots of events. It's going to have to be erased and pretty much impossible. But my ADHD, though, I love it. Try to be careful. I love it. And, you know, it's weird. It might gonna be weird for some people to hear me say that. My ADHD drive my wife crazy, and you know, drive a lot of people crazy. My daughter have ADHD, and I seriously think she's loving it too. My wife don't. But let me tell you, when me and my daughter go on the rampage together, it's a lot, Sadie. And it's a category 5, I tell you. But why I love my ADHD so bad is because my brain work 100 miles an hour, 20 hours a day, even when 24 hours a day. I wake up, I'm bath, ready to go. I already have like 20 plan on my head. And most of the time at the end of the day, I never touch one of those plan because another 20 come by and another 15, and I select what I want to do. And I go there and I have that to do. I need to come back, take care of the dog. Oop, and I have appointment and I have forgot. Oh, we need to go get this. But no, somebody call. Hey, do you want to come help me to get some few hours? Sure, we make a hole in the schedule. We're going to deal with the rest later. My wife is upset because we need to cancel that. My daughter, it's all exciting because now we're going to go see the horse when we was supposed to go somewhere else to she was not wanted to go. On my way there, something else happened. I get stressed out. I'm ready to turn around. Because the nurse doesn't pick up the damn phone. Me and Lisa get in an argument. We turn around. We come down. I turn around again. Go back. Get some horse. and we are back at my 5 or 6 project I have begun. Are you still there? Already lose a couple therapists and psychologists and they never find them yet. That it's every single day of my life. Every day. Every single day. Plus, again, sometimes get a phone call between that from home care or something come up with Anna. The nurse calls, not doing so good. PTSD kick in because I remember some stuff. And then we have the atomic reaction. The beast is up now. And then, oh my God, then I tell you, I've become something else. Blow everything away in front of me. Try to find a little solution for the small problem, the big problem with the small solution, and you know what? Everybody's freaking out, and I don't have any fucking problem. I'm gonna find a solution to it. Okay, put a band-aid on that, control the bleeding. Before we know what the diagnostic is, we're gonna deal with that. Put another band-aid on that one. You have a river to cross there. The problem, it's too big. You build a bridge. You're not sure if the bridge is going to be solid enough to come back. But that's not a big deal. You're going to deal with that later. You need to deal with what is there. Okay. I put a special request to the Canadian government to increase the day from 24 hours to 30. Don't know if they're going to agree with me. But still going. Wake up in the middle of the night. Wake up my wife because I have something to say about what I want to do in a few hours from now. She gets pissed off at me because I doesn't leave her sleep. But she finally agrees what we're going to do. I get up in the morning. Something happened between. She get up. Okay, you go. I'm ready to do this. I say, oh, forgot this. I passed at something else already. You get up too late. Too late, she get up. I told her my idea 5 minutes ago. That is my ADHD. My daughter is supposed to get up at 7 o'clock. I wake her up at 7:01. She's not up. And I say, hey, I'm not going to tell you again, hon. No more patient. Time to get up. Supposed to get up at 7 o'clock. It's 7:01. Let's go. Time to go. Yeah, that is ADHD. Plus, surprise. I know it was there, but I keep an eye on the thing. Because this thing, and the key, and the lighter, the pack of smoke, wallet, sunglasses, cowboy hat, I lose those damn thing 20 times a day. Sometime more. But thanks to my ADHD, like I said, he doesn't have any problem. I deal with 20 problems. You have 25, 30, 40 showing up. Doesn't matter. We keep running. We keep running. We keep running. We keep running. Everybody started to find solution and I still fucking keep going. Never the good solution. Never the perfect solution. But at least can get by. One step at a time. Push all the problem away. Try to deal with my wife with that. Deal with my wife with that. Holy shit, almost choke on that. I tell you. Oh, Lisa, I tell you, I love her. I love her. I love her. I love her. But, Lisa? Look. We all agree on something. Okay? We're on the boat in the middle of the sea there. you have a lot of little, you know, compartment, the boat storage compartment and all that stuff. And, you know, tape, little bucket, patches, everything. Okay. If you see the water coming in the fucking boat and you start fucking crying and you do not stop crying and you pull your hair off and you fucking freak out and we're gonna die and we're not gonna make it and it's not gonna happen and that doesn't fucking stop. Not only Lisa, you know, people with bad depression and anxiety, PTSD, but doesn't have the ADHD to compense with, plus a low self-esteem and they have been put down by so many people in the past to now they do not believe on good things no more. They don't have the energy to keep going. But this kind of stuff, I don't know what that is. Then, when Lisa get on those stage of mind and she just wait to the boat fill up with water and sink, I do what I gotta do. Need to snap her out of this. And when my ADHD kick in mixed with the PTSD and her state of mind, oh, I tell ya, it's not always easy. But if she's in bed crying all damn day long, I will get her over there, doesn't matter what. If I have to pick a fight with her till she get mad, she can find some energy and she bounce back off the bed, and we keep fucking shooting water out of the boat, try to stay afloat. That, my ADHD allowed me to do this, because one situation happened, most people is going to think a little bit, make up with a plan, make a backup plan. Well, I have 20 fucking backup plan, every scenario possible. Then if 20 scenario come up in the day, oof, I lose the mathematics. It's a lot of fucking scenario makeup in my head there. Example, every bad news we got. I try to make a scenario for the worst case scenario possible according to that situation. And the best scenario possible, plus everything between. Then if I hit somewhere in there, I doesn't hit the worst one, I win somewhere. Doesn't go as bad than I was expecting. And you're going to use a very rough example right now to make the difference between me and Lisa. Or between people like me and people like Lisa with more depression state and things like this. All my brain needs to analyze all that. Not so long time ago, a year and I, well, it's going to be 2 years now. Lisa has been a little bit more than 2 years of brain bleed, and yeah, Anna, yeah. It's going to be 2 years soon, pretty soon here. And on the same time, I'm going to be able to, later on, see how my brain is quick, bring up another idea, and because when that happened with Anna, me and Lisa was working with our horse. And that bring also another idea. People say, oh, what do you think? Who the fuck you think he is? That guy wears Superman sign on his chest, Superman tattoo on his back. He's dressed like a cowboy. I gonna cover all this. I have an explication for every single of those things to help me to get better every day. Gonna get there. I was saying, yeah, Anna. 2 years ago, we get up in the morning, and I was looking a little bit off, but it was not too bad at all. And we decided to go on. It's very rare me and Lisa getting out together. I take time for ourselves. Then, you know, well, be honest, we have a doubt, we have no idea. Is going to be as bad, but it was borderline to, you know, should we go, should we not, do we overreact, it's PTSD kicking in, we don't trust anything, and we're always freaking out, and for one, we decide to, you know what, take a breath, release the pressure, and go have some fun for an hour or two, because it's pretty much maximum 3 hours. I cannot tolerate it, even if we have nurses during the day for 8 hours. I cannot tolerate to be out of my house more than 3 hours straight. And that have to be on the perfect condition. If something pisses me off over there or something happened coming back home and doesn't go out for the rest of the day. But anyway, we decide to go through, we go work with the horse. You know, you start to play cowboy, I have no clue what I'm doing. Try to catch that little thing at the beginning. And try to alter that, and she was not even alter broke on nothing. She doesn't want to have nothing to do with Frenchie. Nothing to do with Frenchie, that horse. She don't want to see me, not so ever. But anyway, I be able to get a little bit more friendly with her before, for a few weeks have passed. But that day I have in my head, you know what, honey, today it will happen. I'm going to put a halter on you if you want it or not. I will do it. And it's today, it's happening. I was wrong. Anyway. Be able to pet her and things like that, but impossible to take a grip on that thing, to put a rope around her neck and be able to put her to hold her. And I start getting, you know, not rough with her, but getting frustrating inside. And oh, whatever, I said, doesn't work. I grab the rope, make her lasso on this. I'm not good with fucking lasso. Don't make yourself crazy. But anyway, I be able to reach close enough to I can throw the big damn loop around her neck and grab that thing like cowboy boots on the, you know, the snow there. And there I fucking go, and she dragged me. And you have a little house in her pen where she was. You have only two walls. It's open at the front and it's open on the side and on the direction of the wind. And anyway, long story, doesn't want to lose you in my brain. I bet you start having trouble keeping up already. But anyway, she dragged me and there I went directly for the pole, like skiing my foot. I need to look over the damn rope. And this time, Lisa picked up the phone, is the nurse. And that's not doing good, not good at all. Now the PTSD kick in. And for one, I tell you, I will give my hat. I will lift my hat to my wife, Lisa. Now I have the rope around that horse neck and not going anywhere before I can take off that rope there. Otherwise, something can happen, twist around her legs, and she can get hurt very badly. Try to get close to that thing now. I'm not panicking, but my PTSD kick in, the emotion, they're all over the place. Not a damn chance I can get close to that horse. And I knew it too, right? I knew as much. Then Lisa said, you go get the rope. We need to go. I said, Lisa, not a chance I can get close to that horse. I tried to calm myself down, and I know the clock is going. I know Anna's not going. We are not doing good. We have about 15-minute drive to go. I can, you know, I can see in the face of Lisa to the conversation with the nurse, you know, the nurse was nervous. And anyway, I said, Lisa, I cannot do nothing. Let's go. Fuck what's happened with the horse. I'm sorry to say this. But Lisa went in there. Usually Lisa is the first one to panic on everything. Everything, she lose control. She went in the damn pen with that horse, approached the horse, take the rope off, and catch up on me. I said, you leave her there with a rope on her neck? Do you talk to somebody at the barn, see what they can do? And, oh, she said, get the rope off. She got the rope off the damn horse off. Every time that thing moves, she's jumping from here to there. She's already out the pen. She's been chased out of the pen by that horse. She went inside the pen, take off the rope. Fuck. Anyway, amazing. Okay, what the fuck I was going with this? Anyway. Okay, yeah. I want to explain that how many scenarios I can do in my head. I believe is what it was. I lose myself in my own brain, right? But anyway, we get home. Oh my God, she's not doing good, not so ever. And you know, I've been a volunteer firefighter, helped the EMS a lot. Read a lot about, you know, the sign of, you know, when the end is close, right? And she relieved everything, and you know, she was not responsive, not so ever, bagging her with a high flow of oxygen. The heart rate was start bouncing all over the place, and that it's all the sign to, you know, the discoloration of her skin with some modeling, they call it. The sign was all there. Then anyway, big disaster with the EMS, big disaster. The police involved. They don't want to let me in the ambulance. And anyway, they took off. But I wasn't gonna go all in detail. You have a lot of other events that have happened during that episode. But anyway, I'm with the supervisor of the EMS on this vehicle, and we drive to the stallery. And by then, my brain kicking. I need to figure out. I need to analyze every scenario possible. Okay, the best case scenario, she's gonna get there. And now I'm gonna tell you something. I hit right bullseye. Right bullseye on that. It's very rare that happened, but that day, the best scenario possible have happened. But I imagined them all. I said, okay, the worst case scenario, we're gonna get there, and she's gone. She passed away. First scenario I need to do. Lisa will be the main focus. All my energy, all the medical team, everybody, all the family is going to have to focus on Lisa. I know I have my youngest daughter, Hope, to I can explain where her names come from. Dawson is older. I know I named her name, but anyway, all the family member. But the one who is going to be, the next one who is going to be at very high risk, is will be Lisa, and is where my focus need to be. Try to figure out how we're gonna bring that, and she's gonna know in a way, but how we're gonna react with her, make sure she's gonna get all the support she need. And I always put myself way below. And after that, my daughter, you know, she's very close to her little sister and things like that. How are we gonna bring that to Hope? I already done one with my son. I have to all my stepson to his little brother was not coming at home. Then I said, okay, that's not a big deal. I've done that one. I'm going to do it again. And after that, he passed the scenario if she make it, but with severe brain damage. Because right now, Anna's brain, it's perfection. She's a very smart little girl. She's reacting. She have emotion. She's a very happy little girl. And then what is the brain damage? The worst case scenario is it will be a total brain damage to me and Lisa. Already have to take a decision like that. To, you know, our son, the brain was gone, and they have no point to keep fighting. Then how I'm going to analyze that with Lisa and what the decision are we going to take and going towards the best case scenario, you know, minimum damage to the brain and things like that, or no brain damage, but it's going to be a long go at the hospital, 5 or 6 months, or to bring her back to baseline. Or the best case scenario, we're going to get to the verge. They're going to stabilize her. It's going to take a little while, maybe a little bit in PICU, or best case scenario, directly to the floor, few days at the hospital, back home. Guess what? I hit bang on. When, you know, what's happened here, they even have to do emergency IO to its emergency access directly to the bone marrow on her shoulders. They basically slam that there, screw that on right directly through the bone. Gonna give you fluid and be ready to use reanimation medication if they need to do so. But it never went as far. Show up at the merge on the ambulance bay. She was on a critical situation. Basically, the EMS told me she's not gonna make it. I asked them to give me the status. She just gave me the basic number. I say, hello, how much oxygen you have her on? She was on the maximum flow of oxygen. Well, I remember that is where you have a little bit of confusion, because the EMS told me she was on 35 liters of oxygen, and after that, during the investigation, they say, no, it's not possible. The maximum flow we can give, it's 25 liters of oxygen. Try to make themselves look better, because you can tee those boots all together, put them both at 25 liters of oxygen, and you're going to have, you know, the oxygen, but that they don't. But anyway, what the EMS told me at the beginning, 35 liter of oxygen. After that, anyway, get to the merge. They told me she's not responsive. So I look at her, pinch her a little bit. I knew the language of my daughter when she's very ill, and yeah, she was responsive. Maybe not responsive according to their standard in the EMS vehicle, but she was responsive. And I get to the merge, blood sugar, she was going in shock, she was going septic for some reason, didn't never quite pinpoint when the infection was. Her sugar level was at 20.9, but they bring her back to her acceptable baseline, good enough to, and I believe was on 12 hours, not even, we've been back up on the number floor, on the floor upstairs on the regular care. And we doesn't have to stay at the hospital as long as we was expecting. Then that time around I hit right the perfect scenario, but unfortunately in our case it's not always the case. And I tell you, it's like that is my ADHD brain, and I have to do that. I don't know how many times in the day, phone call for this, phone call for that, and it's what to come when the horse story I wanted to tell you guys, why the horse has become so important for my PTSD, because it's easy for me if you come piss me off. You know, if I doesn't like you, I'm going to kick you out of my house, I'm going to argue with you, you're going to walk away, or I walk away the other way. And if I doesn't like what is going on at the hospital, I grab my daughter, I get out of there. Or if I doesn't like that doctor, I said, get the fuck out of here, bring me another one. Not do that with the 900 pound horse. If something pissed me off or I get a phone call, something's go wrong at home, and I have that horse out of her pen, I need to bring her back. No choice. Doesn't want to have a horse running on fucking Anthony Ende. That has been amazing for me. I cannot even do that with human right now. I just cannot. I get a little bit better, but that is since that horse. If I cannot control myself, don't even think get close to that. She's gonna try to run away, and if you try with her, she's gonna push you. She put her shoulders right in your chest. She push you on the side. She will turn you. She's gonna hit you with your head. And can go at the point where she's gonna bite you, or she's gonna turn and, you know, jackass, you know, yeah, poof, gone. And yeah, that, you know, I learned to control myself, and it's been amazing for me, and it works great. And you know, Lisa can tell the difference at home, and that's why I like my journey with the horse. And people say, oh, is this first horse? And now I walk around with cowboy boots and cowboy hat on, and you know, rodeo belt and Superman shirt. Well, let me guess. Let me tell you something. Yes, I'm a cowboy. I am. I doesn't Bronx. No, I do Bronx fucking good. I Bronx with life every day. Every single day I Bronx with life. Get throw off, eat dust, get kick, get bit every single day. But I handle the holy shit handle. I fall off the horse, I eat some dust, and I jump back on because I enjoy the damn ride. And every single ride they're going to give me, I'm going to kneel if I have to. Gonna catch my breath, and I'm gonna jump back on. And that's the Canadian cowboy. My own definition of cowboy. Not because of my horse. I doesn't even know what I'm doing with horse. Do my best, and I hope for the best, and I make scenario, and if I hit somewhere, I'm happy. But I learned though, every day. I learned about horses, and I learned about my own mental health. And try to make people understand how people like me and Lisa's failing every day. Yeah, every day. And for the Superman shirt and the Superman tattoo in my back, I'm gonna talk about that a little bit. Okay, first of all, I'm gonna try to find something quick here. I'm not very good with technology, then please take a breath, because I'm sure it was, might be a little bit hard to keep up with. But it's all my brain's going every day. And I know I have told you guys before in the past to... I'm blind. Okay. I talk about Christopher Reeve in the past, right? I'm always journey and all I have follow him. And, you know, I have done some stuff with my daughter and, you know, retreat and you know, all the research you have done for spinal injury and things like that. I'm going to try to find a short quote here too. I like reading the quote of Christopher Reeve every so often. And I seriously will tell you guys to, I will suggest, you know, you can do what you want, but if you guys can read some of those quotes and absolutely don't feel anything, and don't feel any emotion, and after that reading this, going back for the one who they are a big fan of, Donald Trump and Alex Jones and Steve Bannon and stuff like that, and go back and watching the bullshit, and after that, you know, go back to your normal life like anything happened. And it's something else. Now I'm going to read one here. I'm not a very good reader, like I'm French, like I said. An arrow in an ordinary individual who find the strength to persevere, endure, in spite, I'm blind, in spite of overwhelming obstacle. Basically, a hero is an ordinary person like me and you who struggle every day and try to get by, but doesn't matter what's going on in your life, you're going to find the strength to overcome those obstacles. And that's go on and on and on. I'm going to try to find another one that I love. It's my favorite one. Gonna try to find it here. It's my favorite quote of I will like to read it properly. Anyway, the quote Christopher Reeve said, I cannot find it obviously, and after that we're gonna pass at something else about the explication of, you know, the logo of Superman is just because I think I'm a superhero. We have a lot more behind this. But the quote of Christopher Reeve, my favorite one is, we all have a little voice inside us. Might be God, I don't know. But if we shut down all the noise and the clutter inside us and follow that voice will guide us and tell us the right thing to do. And that, if you take time to think about all this and you analyze what we see in the American politics or everywhere around the world, I seriously think people should read Christopher Reeve quote a little bit more and take time to think about it. And I know on my past video I have explained, you know, the meaning of, you know, the Superman logo in my back and the reason why I did what I did, and, you know, the reason why I like wearing Superman shirt. I'm gonna show you guys the trailer of Man of Steel here. And you know, sometimes Hollywood people say, oh, it's only a movie and blah 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 blah. But let me tell you something, you have a lot of good messages on those movies and lots of things I can relate to, and lots of people can relate to as well. And I'm gonna go on with the video, and I'm gonna pause it. It's only a 3-minute introduction to Men of Steel, but we're gonna talk about it. See, right there, you know, I can attach to my son and things like that. You know, they wanted us to abort our son because they discover he have hydrocephalus, and they push very strongly to try to push us for the abortion. And me and my wife have the discussion and things like that, and that's why when they say they will kill him, he will be an outcast and things like that. I can, you know, the doctor have told us, you guys going to be the one who's going to have to deal with another handicapped child. It's basically what we have been said, and we decide to go through with it. And
what if a child dreamed of becoming something other than what society had intended? What if a child aspired to something greater?
My son was in the bus. He saw what Clark did.
You're the answer, son. You're the answer to are we alone in the universe?
Can I just keep pretending I'm your son?
You are my son. I have to believe that you were sent here for a reason. And even if it takes the rest of your life, you owe it to yourself to find out what that reason is.
How do you find someone who has spent a life?
Okay, right there. I love that part as well, because, you know, with all the fight we have done with Anna, and me and Lisa always have the discussion, you know, Anna is here for a reason. And she have her own purpose. Doesn't matter what her condition is. And, you know, we can see the spark in her eye, and she wanted to fight. And we wanted to find what is going to be the purpose for her. And, you know, I doesn't want to say we give her the much perfect life. You know, very far away from that. We do our best every day. We can be a lot better, but we all have our struggle. But everybody have a purpose. And it's just a question to, you know, discover your own purpose. And lots of people with mental health, they say, oh, I want to die, I don't have any purpose. Everybody have a purpose. Do not forget that ever. It's just for you to try to find what is your purpose, who's going to give you the reason to want to keep going. At the beginning, don't set yourself, oh, you know what, I'm going to get out of that thing in 25 years, I'm going to be millionaire. And then, you know, don't look at this that way. Just find a small purpose who's going to allow you to take one step at a time, and you cannot start running before you start walking. And right now, you lay down right to the ground, you're right down to your below. Then, you know, give yourself a chance, and it's one step at a time. And it's what I like about this, you know, it's a Hollywood movie. He speak to his son about, you know, it's the proof to his other life in the space. But I mean, forgot that part. The part is the dad who talked to his son, tried to guide him to do the better choice without judgment. And it's what is the message behind it. And everybody said, oh, you watch too much movie, you go. No, I don't. Every movie have good message like this, is you won't take time to hear it.
Uncovering his tracks. For some, he was a guardian angel.
I miss it.
Ghost, who never quite
wanted to stop it when you see him struggle. I'm gonna see if I can.
Lifetime covering his tracks. guardian angel.
See that? That is us every day. That is us with mental health every day. Every single day. Some pass through it, some don't. I'm not gonna give up. I won't. Because he don't.
For others, a ghost who never quite fit in.
Not quite fit in! How many of us with mental health? We are not quite fit in. Is it? No reason to give up, isn't it?
You will give the people of Earth an ideal to strive towards. They will race behind you. They will stumble. They will fall. But in time, they will join you in the sun. In time, you will help them accomplish wonders.
One time. At one point. We need to all come together and fix this shit. Yeah, all come together and fix this shit. But you need to have one good person at the front of all of us. It's crazy, ain't they gonna say, holy fuck, the friend, she's losing it. But no, you know, before you judge me, take time to think about what I tell you. Best part's coming up.
You believe your son is safe?
I will!
Donald Trump, Alex Jones, Steve Bannon. Look at it. Isn't it? Huh? We have some of those. Do we?
My father believed if the world found out where I really was, they'd reject me. He was convinced that the world wasn't ready. What do you think?
Scared. Scared to talk about stuff. Because we believe it will not change anything. And scared of the judgment. Scared to create chaos. We know what that is. What do you think?
What's the S stand for?
It's not an S. In my world, it means hope.
Well, here it is.
Means hope. That word on my chest. Doesn't give me superpower. Give me hope. That's what it does. Tattoo on my back. Give me hope. My youngest daughter name, it's Hope. Find a purpose.
An ass. How about... See?
Excuse me.
It's what I have to do every day. Fight for my family and try to make sure what's happened to me doesn't happen to too many of you. That's why Lisa's doing what she's doing. That's why I'm doing what I'm doing. That's why sometimes I take decision to, I put myself in the pickle and I put my family in the pickle. Because I believe what I'm doing. And you have certain principles that I do not accept. You know? Like some political parts you would like to do. You know? Money, 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 money. prefer to save your big house, or don't want, refuse to bring down your quality of life for the very rich people that doesn't talk about people who seriously doesn't have nothing. To do the wrong thing, lie to people, try to create chaos. Do illegal shit. Intimidate people. And on and on and on. For get more money in your pocket. You seriously think Donald Trump care about you guys or about us here? You know, you're not smart. I'm not a smarter pea in the pie. I will not deny that. But if you do believe Donald Trump, Alex Jones, Steve Bannon care about you guys, think again. Because you're wrong. Do not give a damn. Fortunately, that is only my opinion. But if more people will talk like this, and, you know, every time they see the little tough guy there doing some intimidation there at the pole there, bring your Nerf gun out. Go play with them. Yeah, some crazy people there, I cannot deny that. And, you know, sometimes you can talk too much, no doubt about it. I think about this every time I open my mouth. I have lots of trouble. I cannot keep that damn thing shut. And you just go. When I have something to say, poof, God. It's who I am. Like it or not. And for the one who laugh about my cowboy outfit, oh, is his first horse and he think he's a cowboy. Now you understand that. The reason behind it. Superman sign, you know the reason behind it. Glasses is because my eyes are red right now. I went for a walk with the dog outside. And anyway, like I was saying, he's going to have some subject is going to be boring. Some subject is going to be interesting. Some subject is going to be maybe stupid for some people, but with a lot of meaning for me and other people out there. Not the only one that way. But I mean, every movie like this, you have some good message behind it. And if we take time, you know, I know when I was young, when I was going through a rough time, watching a superhero movie was taking me right out of it. And, you know, I can go through everything. Man of Steel. And, you know, it's good to attach yourself. What I like to do is, you know, do some projection. Try to compare my mid-school, our mid-school life, and attach that to some fiction thing, and attach that to the real life on a daily basis. Just like the boat story, when Lisa has a reaction, if we just panic, well, if you just panic and the water rises, you might have all the tools around you to save your life, but because you panic, you're going to miss it. You're going to miss it. And then lots of people die that way, just because they cannot control their emotion. But anyway, please subscribe to my channel. And, you know, if you have some people with ADHD, PTSD there and will like to send me a message on private, feel free of it 24 hours a day. If I picked up, I picked up. If I don't, I don't. And if you annoy me, I'm going to tell you. And if I know you, let me know. And I'm going to try to demix all this. Send some comment. Subscribe. And, yeah, let's take that again tomorrow, maybe. I should be, I talk enough for today, isn't it? And have some Skittle, a coffee or two. Try to go bad later. Yeah, have a good evening, guys.
This morning, they were like race cars. All of them. All three of them. Running around everywhere like little race cars.
Wait a second, let me catch my breath.
And
remind me how it feels to hear your voice.
You got the morning blues.
Your lips are moving like
take the pills!
Oh god, you scared me.
Living life as a reality. Anywhere, anytime, I would do anything for you. Anything for you. Yesterday got away. Melody stuck inside your head. I soak in every breath. Sing. Sing me, sing, won't you sing?